Hi everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts and my Facebook page Dr. Srinivas Concepts. This is Dr. Srinivas, neurologist from Andhra Pradesh, India. I am also the medical author of the book Focused Neurology. Today we'll talk about an interesting topic, diplopia, a double vision. So today we'll talk about diplopia, double vision. What is this double vision and diplopia? It is nothing but seeing a single object as double. So if we see a single object as double, we call that as double vision or diplopia. So when we see a single object as double, we call it as double vision or diplopia. So what are the types of diplopia? Basically, there are two types of diplopia. One, monocular diplopia, where you see double vision only with one eye. Second is the binocular diplopia, where when we see with two eyes, you get double vision. So how to differentiate between monocular diplopia and binocular diplopia? In monocular diplopia, if you close the affected eye, the double vision disappears. Imagine I find diplopia with my right eye, and therefore when I close my right eye, the diplopia disappears. This is not that much dangerous, and these are usually not neurological. They are due to ophthalmologic causes, because of the problems with the lens or because of the problems with cornea. So this is monocular diplopia. Binocular diplopia is seeing double vision when we use both eyes together. So how do you find this binocular double vision or diplopia? Here you have to close both eyes but separately. For example, if I have binocular diplopia, I need to close one eye and see whether the diplopia disappears or not, and continue the process by closing the second eye also after some time. Because if I close only one eye and it happens to be a monocular diplopia because of this eye, the diplopia disappears and we may get confused whether it is monocular or binocular diplopia. And therefore, to test binocular diplopia, first we have to close the one eye. It could be affected eye or non-affected eye, and then you have to close the other eye. So if it disappears, then it is binocular diplopia. Binocular diplopia is because of neurological causes. To understand the cause and the reasons for binocular diplopia, we need to understand certain principles. The macula is the area of the highest visual acuity. So when we look at an image, it falls on the macula of both the eyes, and therefore the image appears sharp and clear. But imagine one of the eyes is non-functional. I mean the nerve. When one of the nerves of one eye is not functioning properly, the image does not fall exactly on the macula. It falls on the perimacular region. So if the image is seen with the normal eye, the image falls on the macula, which is called as the real image, and it appears sharp. Simultaneously, if there is a cranial nerve palsy, for example, sixth nerve palsy, lateral rectus palsy, therefore I can't move my eye laterally, and therefore what happens, the image falls nasally, on the nasal retina. So when the image falls on the nasal retina, which does not fall exactly on the macula but the perimacular area, the image appears blurred, because it is not falling on macula, it is falling on the perimacular area. And therefore, since it is falling on the perimacular area, the extra macular vision is in the region which is not acute, and the image appears blurred, which we call it as a false image. So the more further the image is projected, the more further is the image falling on the retina away from the macula. So if the image falls more and more away from the macula, the image is more and more projected peripherally. So the more it falls away from the macula, the more it is projected peripherally. So because of these principles, we can have two rules based on these principles. One, rule number one, the direction in which the images are maximally separated indicates the action of the pair of muscles at fault. So the direction in which the images are maximally separated indicates the action of the pair of muscles at fault. Example, imagine if my right lateral rectus and left medial, right lateral rectus is at fault. So what happens when I look to the right? The images are maximally separated, and the pair of muscles responsible for the maximal separation of images when I look to the right could be either my right lateral rectus or left medial rectus. So the direction in which the images are maximally separated, example right lateral rectus or medial rectus, indicates the action of the pair of weak muscles. In this case, when you look to the right horizontal gaze, it is either because of right lateral rectus or left medial rectus. And the second rule is that the images projected further away from the center is attributable to the eye with the parotid muscle. So the more the image is projected peripherally, that is attributed to the weak muscle. So the image projected further from the center is attributable to the eye with the parotid muscle. For example, in this case, the right lateral rectus and left medial rectus, imagine now this is a true image and false image. So the more further, it is because of the pair of weak muscles, and therefore the image which is projected more further, it is attributable to the weak muscle. And here I would like to tell one more important point. If you get horizontal diplopia on looking at far off object, it is because of the lateral rectus palsy. If you get horizontal diplopia more on looking at near objects, it is medial rectus palsy. Right. Now, to understand these two principles, we need to understand the action of the muscles, the primary action and the secondary action. The action of the medial rectus is adduction, and the nerve supplying the medial rectus is third nerve, and there is horizontal crossed diplopia when the medial rectus is involved. I'll talk about crossed diplopia and uncrossed diplopia soon. So if the medial rectus is involved, you will get a horizontal but crossed diplopia. If the lateral rectus is involved, you get horizontal diplopia, but it is uncrossed. If the superior rectus is affected, superior rectus primary action is elevation and secondary action is intorsion. So the superior rectus is applied, which is supplied by the third nerve, there is verticular diplopia. The images are projected superiorly and more when it is abducted. When you have inferior rectus, the primary action of inferior rectus is depression and extorsion. It is supplied by third nerve. There is vertical diplopia. Here, it is more downward and it is seen more when it is abducted. The superior rectus and inferior rectus, the superior rectus lifts the eye upwards, the inferior rectus pulls the eye downward, but they are acted best when they are in the abduction position. Then we have superior oblique and inferior oblique. Superior oblique main action is intorsion, the primary action. Secondary action is depression. It is supplied by the fourth nerve. Here again there is vertical diplopia, but it is best when it is downward and adducted. Then you have inferior oblique, whose primary action is extorsion. It is second reaction is elevation. It is supplied by the third nerve. Here also you have vertical diplopia, but it is more on superior and when it is adducted. The superior oblique and inferior oblique are at best when they are adducted, but the actions are different. Superior oblique depresses the eye muscle and inferior oblique elevates the eye. So these are the primary actions and secondary actions. To understand this crossed diplopia and uncrossed diplopia, we need to understand an important principle. For example, imagine this is a red paper I am putting on my right eye. Traditionally red colored paper is put on the right, and imagine this is green put on my left. So when I look to the right, and suppose my right lateral rectus and left medial rectus are affected. So when I look to the right horizontally, I get diplopia. If I get diplopia looking to the right and images are maximally separated, it could be either because of my right lateral rectus or left medial rectus. So when I put the red paper on my right eye and green on the left eye and light projected 1 meter away, and then see which images are moved further apart from the center, there are two possibilities. One, they are maximally separated. Two, either the red can be on the extreme right and the green can be slightly medial, or the other way around, the green can be extremely lateral and right can be medial, right? This red color paper is on my right eye corresponding to lateral rectus. The green color paper is on my left eye corresponding to my medial rectus. So now what happens? There is a maximum separation of images when I look to the right. Fine. So this is because of either my right lateral rectus or left medial rectus. If the image, for example, if the this is the false image, which is the red color, is further away from the green, that means it indicates my right lateral rectus palsy. The image has gone further away. Okay. But what happens when I draw the false image with the eye and the true image with my left eye? What happens? The direction right to the right and left here, the red colored paper which corresponds to right eye and green colored paper which corresponds to my left eye, they maintain the same direction. So the alignment is maintained. So this you call it as uncrossed diplopia, because it is not crossing. This is like this and this is like this. It is uncrossed, right? And therefore, when you draw a line from the false image to the right eye and the true image to the left eye, it has not crossed. So this you call as uncrossed diplopia. It is because of my lateral rectus palsy. Imagine if there is a medial rectus palsy. Now the green colored paper which represents my left eye moves further apart, because now medial rectus is inward. So the green colored paper moves away from the red colored paper. So red colored paper is a true image corresponds to my right eye. The right green colored paper is a false image which corresponds to my left eye. Now what happens when I draw a line from the red eye, true image, to my right eye, and then another line from the green color paper, the false image, to the left eye? It bisects. The line bisects. In other words, it is crossed. The green color paper which represents my left eye has crossed the red color paper which is represents my right eye, has crossed and gone to the other side. So this you call as crossed diplopia. So medial rectus produces crossed diplopia. Medial rectus produces crossed diplopia, whereas lateral rectus produces uncrossed diplopia. So this is a very important concept. So by knowing the basic principles of the image falling on the macula or the perimacular area, which represents true image and false image, and by knowing these two rules and then looking at their false image, whether it is medial or lateral to the true image, we can make out whether it is a cross diplopia or uncrossed diplopia. Hope you have understood the basics of diplopia and double vision, and hope you have enjoyed this lecture. If you have any doubts or query, you can post your comments on my YouTube channel, Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts. I'll answer to all your comments and queries. If you have liked the lecture, please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Dr. Srinivas Medical Concepts, and my FB page, Dr. Srinivas Concepts. Thank you. Bye.